Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we are going to see common uses of virtualization. So, first is virtualizing desktop computers. Desktop virtualization is often called a client virtualization. It is a virtualization technology used to separate a computer desktop environment, and that environment is given to a client in a different platform. Desktop virtualization is considered a type of client-server computing because the virtualized desktop is stored in a centralized. It's in maybe a cloud, and the user will only get a desktop screen in that particular mobile device or a laptop device or any other type of devices. Desktop virtualization virtualizes a desktop computers, and this virtual desktop environment is served to users on a network or on a cloud. You interact with a virtual desktop as the same way you are using your desktop computers. Another benefit of desktop virtualization is you can remotely log in into that virtualized desktop, and you can use from your mobile devices, tablet, desktop or a laptop. In this picture, we can see that this is our desktop virtualization, where this desktop is centralized in particular place. It may be a cloud or a centralized server. So from the users can access this desktop from the laptop, from the mobile or a tablet or a desktop PC. Next common use of virtualization is running a specific program. One of the best software known as a desktop virtualization is XenApp and Xen Desktop. Provide a secure remote access to the employees for cutting a IT cost. Because if you want just a desktop virtualization, you no need to pay for a full physical machine. Another major provider is a VMware with a platform called VMware Horizon 7. Microsoft is another provider with a combination of remote desktop service and with a Hyper-V. Next common use of virtualization is setting up the test and a development environment. This is a most useful common use of the virtualization. In this virtualization, one of the most powerful feature of the virtualization environment is possible to create a labs for your particular use. So this approach in a minute, especially the software development, and then we can use that environment for the post-production. These are the common usage of the virtualization. In our next video, we are going to see what is hypervisor.